Hi guys, welcome to my channel. I'm John. Today I'm going to share with you how to build a Cinema 4D cloner in Blender 3D 2.93. First, select all and delete everything. Press Shift A and add a plane. Press N to toggle the properties channel and change the dimension to 8.5. Press A again to add a cylinder. Change the vertices to 6, the radius to 0.4 and the depth to 3.8. So I have to apply the scale for the plane. And press G and Y to move it beside. And now we can start to add a geometry node to the plane here. Press Shift A and add a point instance and select the instance object. Press Shift A again to add a joint geometry. Connect it. And now we can see all the instance objects are applied on the vertices of the plane, and we actually need more instance objects on the plane. To add more instant object on the plane, we need to add more vertices on the plane in order to make it clone onto the point. But before we do it, we have to select the instant object here, go to edit mode, and we need to set the origin to stick at the bottom of the cylinder. To do it, select the vertices at the bottom here, press Shift S, and select the cursor to selected, exit edit mode, and go to object, set origin, and select origin to 3D cursor. Okay, and now we can start to add more vertices onto the plane. Press Shift A and add a subdivision surface. And make sure we untick the boundary smooth and change the level to 3. Let's move this side so we have more space. Now we want to add a attribute randomize. And we can name the attribute minimum size and change the max value to 0. Duplicate another again and we name this maximum size and change the minimum and maximum value to 1. Why we are doing this is because later when we finish set up everything, when the Falloff starts the plane, then if you trigger the maximum size here, then the area that not touched by the Falloff will trigger the minimum size here, which is nothing happened. Okay, now we add a attribute mix before the instant object. Hover this and press Ctrl C to copy it, and hover the column A here and press Ctrl V to paste it. And now we do the same thing for minimum size. Paste it at the B column here and we type scale at the result column here. And now we can play with the factor and we slide the factor to A point if you trigger the maximum size, and if we push it to B, it will trigger the minimum size. Okay, now we add a attribute vector map. Change this to distance and change the B column to vector. And now we want to add in a Falloff. Press Shift A and add an empty sphere. And now we want to add the empty sphere to the geometry nodes as a Falloff. Press Shift A and add an object info node. select the empty. We can actually name it Falloff. Connect the location to B. And this is to let the plane know the location of the empty sphere when we move it. The plane will know where is the empty sphere. And type position into the A column. This is to get all the point position on this plane, the vertices point, and we can name the result distance A. We are actually store the calculation result of this node in the distance A, and then now we want to add in a attribute map. Change this to divide and this to float, and we can connect the scale here to B and copy this distance A to the A column here and name the result distance B. And now in the attribute mix, we can change the factor to attribute and copy the distance B to factor here. Okay, now our Falloff is start to work. But now we have a problem. All the instant objects that not triggered by the Falloff, the scale is invert and that's not what we want. What we want is actually, we wanted the scale to zero and we don't want to see anything at the bottom of the plane. To solve the problem, we can add an attribute color ramp before the attribute mix and copy the distance B to paste it here. And now we solve it. And we can connect the point instant object to the group input. And we change the name to instant object. And next time, when we want to change the instant object, we want to change another different instant object to clone, we can straight away change it here. Okay, now we done for the cloner, and that's all for part 1. In part 2 video, I will continue to finish this artwork by adding more details and material to the cylinder and the floor. So if you like my video, please subscribe and see you next week. Bye.